survive, who isn't scared to paint, and who isn't scared to fly, who's got the heart of a lion and the beautiful mind. This is a poem for the dog.
Hey guys, in this video I'm going to show you a simple technique on how to achieve cells in acrylic pouring. So this technique is going to be a flip cup, which is super easy for beginners. I decided to just go straight paint today. I didn't mix my paints like I usually do. All my pieces are custom mixed paints today. They're just very straightforward for the example. So I'm using Arteza, and what I'm doing is I'm using yellow, magenta, and a form of cyan. So here I have a deep yellow by Arteza, magenta light, and phthalo blue, and then I also have titanium white and the Liquitex. So in order to achieve cells, there's a couple of things that you need to know. So these paints I mixed with my Floetrol, and that's going to be in an upcoming tutorial about how I mix my paints. But for now, if you saw the first half of this tutorial, you'll know a gist of kind of how to mix it, or you can use your own recipe. But for now, we're going to stick with the cyan, magenta, yellow, titanium white, always titanium white. I'm also going to be adding the coconut milk into here. That's what I use in my old bottle because it's easier with a dropper. And so no custom mix paints today. The second hack I wanna teach you is, I'm doing a 5x5 canvas just to show you the simple technique, but what I did was, in the cup that I'm flipping with, I took a thumbtack and I put two holes in it. And what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to cover those holes with tape. And so what that does is it gives me something that once I flip my cup, I can relieve the pressure without lifting it. So what I do is I always make sure I can get it back up because I suck at that. So I'm gonna just cover those holes and then you're just gonna fill it like you normally would. So for the paints, white, I never add any silicone to my white. Or coconut hair serum, whatever oil you're using, never to my white. So the three colors I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add 4 drops into each color. Okay, so everybody wonders, do you mix? I do. So I'm gonna just mix it, not very rough, but enough to get the oil to the bottom of the cup. And I'm gonna do that to all the colors. This trick is super easy. I'm hoping that it helps a bunch of you. So the tricks that I use to layer my cups. So for this, let me put my gloves on. So what I'm going to do is, I'm always going to start with white first. Titanium white, I use titanium white because it's a heavy pigment, and so by putting it at the bottom, when you flip your cup, it will sink and it will make the other colors rise. So that's one trick. The next trick is a good rule of thumb, which I don't always follow and I sometimes kick myself for, is layering your cups from light to dark. So I'm gonna do yellow, magenta, cyan, and I always like to top off with a little bit of white because that also makes the colors in there sink. I notice if I raise my cup a little higher, it tends to form a stream. All right. So that's kind of the reaction you should be seeing. Let's get this guy out of the way. Now, when it comes to flipping your cup, I'm not one of those people that can just, you know, flip it on there. I can't do that. So what I do is I take the cup, and I flip my canvas. And then I hold both in all in one motion. Make sure they're kind of centered. I flip. Now, don't mind my messy fingers. The pressure in that cup will stay until you release your tape. Now hold on to the cup when you release it, because it will float. It definitely will float, see? Like if I let it. So I'm gonna just hold it down there for a second. You can already see some really cool solids happening. I don't know, maybe like 15, 20 seconds. And then I will do my flip. Come on, guys. Okay, so before I tilt, I always like get the air bubbles out. Now the reason I came up with this trick were for these pores. I have my cardboard corner. I'm gonna just corner my edge and tilt. This prevents you from losing that coolness, but it also sticks to the edge, so it helps you cover it. So I'm gonna do that to all four corners. Now I'll also be going over in a later tutorial how to determine how much paint you need. Everybody asks me, oh, it looks like a lot of paint. Sometimes it is, but when I do it this way, I have more control over what parts I lose, which is kind of cool, because who doesn't want to have some control? And now, I notice that I have a lot of yellow. So what I'm gonna do, so this is where control comes in. In order to get those cells, you need to get some of the paint off. So if you get some of the paint off and come back, you will eventually be able to create the cells that get stuck underneath. And I don't like to mess with them too much, because they do dry a little lighter. Not as far as hue, but I do like that. And cells will also continue to rise. So just kind of let it do. Excuse me. Let it do its thing while I do my thing. Learn how to talk. So there you have it. And I mean, if you use less paint, if you use different colors, if you move it a little more, play with it, see what happens. But it's a start, and it's a super cool way to get cells. So that's it, guys. That's the super simple hack for fluid art acrylic pouring cells. If you like this little hack, make sure you comment. I want to see some awesome cells from you guys. Make sure you subscribe. There are more tutorials, more hacks, more fun, more healing to come. And if you missed the first half of this tutorial where we went over the fundamentals of fluid acrylic and acrylic pouring, you might want to check that out in the links below. It's by email only. But yeah, here it is. All right, guys, continue to pour your art out. And as always, be yourselves.
Seems like the more time passes, the less I know. People will change, there will be pain, these winds will blow.